First time.
So it just hit my radar that the Batgirl movie was shelved by Warner Bros. Discovery, according to articles. But I didn't believe it, because the master of Insider Scoop said it wasn't true. Wait, never mind. Yeah, so the Batgirl movie has been cancelled, or shelved as they like to put it, and won't be released theatrically or on HBO Max. I'm a bit surprised, but honestly, I forgot that this was coming out. We haven't had an update on it since the beginning of the year, and apparently they wrapped filming a few months ago, and were actually doing test screenings. And according to some articles, they were in the final stages of post-production before they were cancelled. I've been seeing rumors circulate that apparently the reception from the test screenings wasn't that good, and instead of going back and change things, Warner Bros. Just decided to drop the project instead. Now, I'm not gonna dance on the grave of the Batgirl movie like I do when the CW shows get cancelled, because unlike those shows, I don't dislike Batgirl. In fact, I'm pretty indifferent to this whole project. But I want to take a few minutes to give you my two cents on the situation, and really just speculate about what's going on with Warner Brothers. So articles and fans speculate that now that the merger has gone through between Discovery and Warner Brothers, creating Warner Brothers Discovery, the new head honchos in charge are cutting projects that won't see a big return, or are too risky. Basically, they don't want to waste the money unless they know it's going to be a surefire success. And Batgirl was a movie that was in development before the merger happened, and apparently it cost $70 million initially, but due to COVID restrictions and delays, the budget started creeping closer to $90 or $100 million to make. So I guess they just didn't see that as a sound investment, especially when you start factoring in how much it would cost to market the film and to release it internationally. So it appears that they're just kicking it to the curb. But this just raises a few questions, for me anyway. If the movie is done, why not release it? You already spent the money. It was in post-production. If they aren't confident that it'll be a box office hit, they can just release it on HBO Max like they were going to do originally. Because back when they first announced this film, it was marketed as an HBO Max exclusive. And then later on, they said it'll be released theatrically as well. So might as well just reverse the decision and go along with the original plans. So who really knows the real reason to why they cancelled it? Now, even though it's kind of funny to dunk on the fans of Batgirl, because a lot of them were dunking on Snyderverse fans for wanting Justice League Part 2, I think we should take a step back and really take a look at this, because I think it does make the future of other films less likely to happen now. If they shelved Batgirl, a movie that was already filmed, that was in post-production, who's to say they wouldn't cancel a movie that's currently being filmed like Blue Beetle? A lot of fans actually were curious about this, so a fan messaged the director to see if the movie was cancelled, and according to him, they're still fine. Although the directors of Batgirl didn't know the movie was cancelled until everyone else did, you know, when it was announced. So that can quickly change and happen out of nowhere. But to really add to the theory that Warner Bros. Discovery wants to cut their costs and only focus on projects that will actually make them money, if you go back to a couple months ago, when all those CW shows got cancelled, that happened not long after the merger went through. And Warner Bros. Was one of the corporations that funded the CW network and allowed them to use their IPs. But since the ratings were in the toilet and the shows were pretty bad, Warner Bros. Discovery just pulled the plug on them. So it's not really a stretch to assume they'd be doing the same thing with their movies. But again, that's just speculation. I mean, hell, they don't have many projects set to release at the moment, at least in terms of DC comic book movies. There's what, Black Adam, Shazam Fury of the Gods, Aquaman The Lost Kingdom, The Flash, and Blue Beetle. They don't really have that many live action movies to begin with. Speaking of The Flash, people have been mentioning that it's crazy that Batgirl got cancelled, seemingly out of nowhere, but The Flash movie is still a go despite all the controversy around the lead, Ezra Miller. And I think it's because of two reasons. Number one, they easily dumped more than $70 or $100 million into The Flash movie, as well as much more time. So they're going to release it even if it kills them. But second, and more importantly, The Flash movie is going to be introduced in the multiverse, and overall is going to be a more important movie to the future of the DCEU. That may sound mean, but it's true. The Flash is just a more important movie that Warner Bros. Sunk more money and more time into than Batgirl. Although my predictions with The Flash movie is they're going to release it, then drop Ezra Miller from the role, and bring in someone else to either play Wally West or another version of Barry Allen. That's why I think they've been very hush-hush about The Flash movie and about Ezra Miller's actions in general. They want all the controversy to eventually blow over, release the movie, then drop Ezra Miller, and just move on. But yeah, like it or not, The Flash is a bigger, more important film that they already put more time and money into, so I really doubt they're going to cancel it. Honestly, the real tragedy here is not being able to see Brendan Fraser as Firefly. The man is making a career comeback, and we're going to be robbed of this performance. Although we still get to see him in the new Scorsese film, so that's going to be cool. You guys think I'm joking, but Brendan Fraser is low-key a really good actor. Well, I can't say that I'm actually saddened by this news because I wasn't looking forward to it in the first place. But here's a word of advice to some Batgirl fans from a Snyderverse fan. Get them hashtags ready, plan your days, and pick your times, and tweet and spread the word. And good luck. Although there are rumors that Warner Bros. Discovery could write off the money they used on the Batgirl film on their taxes. That way they can recuperate some of the money they spent on the film's budget. And if that happens, then they legally won't be allowed to monetize off the project at all. That means no theatrical release, no release on streaming services, hell, can't even sell it to another studio. So that means there will be no real chance for it to ever get released, unless some brave producer or director wants to leak it online and just hope that they don't get caught. Oh, so as I'm recording this, it came to my attention that an animated Scooby-Doo movie was also canceled at the same time. That apparently cost $40 million to make and was going to be an HBO Max exclusive. So I guess this adds to the theory that they're cutting projects that don't guarantee success. So keep our eyes open and see what else happens in the next couple months, because it seems like this is just the beginning. But that's going to do it for the video. Hope you guys enjoyed. If you did, go and drop a like on it. And leave a comment. Let me know, what do you think about the Batgirl movie getting canceled? Were you looking forward to it? Do you care? Leave a comment. Let me know. And we'll give a nice big shout out to the channel members. There are better things to spend money on, and I'm honored that you decided to spend it on me. If you're interested in becoming a channel member, click the join button down below. And if the perks interest you, consider joining. Or not. It don't matter.
None of this matters.
Every single one of them. And not just the men, but the women and the children.